أبا الفضل العباس ابن أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب صلوات الله وسلامه عليه was born on the 4th of Sha'ban in the 26th year of the Hijra in the holy city of Medina and was martyred on the 10th of Muharram in the 61st year of the Hijra on the plains of Karbala. He is revered to being the embodiment of patience, bravery, and courage, and loyalty. And indeed, he is viewed as being one of the most ferocious warriors in the religion of Islam. For indeed, you see, Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullah wa salamuhu alayha, was martyred in the 11th year after Hijrah. Abbas ibn Ali was born on the 26th year after Hijrah. Hence you find there is a 15-year gap between the martyrdom of Fatima al-Zahra and the birth of Qamar bani Hashim Aba al-Fadl al-Abbas. The question that arises is, did Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib marry Ummul Baneen straight away or no? Amir al-Mu'mineen married a number of women. For example, he married Umamah. He married Asma bint Umays, the mother of Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr. He married Khawla bint Ja'far, the mother of Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyyah. And then he wanted to marry a lady whom will bring him a son or sons that are the bravest of warriors. And hence, he married Umm al-Baneen. What did he do? He went to Aqil, his brother. He said to him, in Medina at that time, in the Rasulullah's mosque, inside the mosque, there were four individuals who would sit on carpets. They would sit on individual carpets. One of them was Aqil. Amir al-Mu'mineen went up to Aqil. He was known, these people were known to being the people of Ansab, the genealogies. He went up to his brother. He said to him, oh my brother, I want you to find me a lady whom will bring me from her, whom from her ancestors, they have the bravest of warriors. Aqil said to him, give me 1 month and I will find you that lady. Aqil went, he did his research and he came back and he came back after a month and he said to Amir al-Mu'mineen, I have found you the lady and there is only this one lady. Amir al-Mu'mineen said, who is it? He said, it's Fatima al-Kilabiyya. He said, what's her ancestry? He said, she has some of the most ferocious warriors as her ancestors. Aqil said to him, have you heard of Mula'ab al-Asinna? Amir al-Mu'mineen said, yes. Do you know Mula'ab al-Asinna? What his hobby was? His hobby was that he would be chasing wild animals. Instead of the wild animals chasing him, he would chase them. Then he mentioned Amr bin Sa'sa'a, who was a renowned wrestler of the lions. Then he mentioned Abu al-Barra and al-Mulahhal. He mentioned the ancestry one by one, proving to Amir al-Mu'mineen that Fatima al-Kilabiyya has the bravest and the most courageous and ferocious of warriors as her ancestors. Amir al-Mu'mineen married her. When she came into his house, she said to him, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, I want you to change my name. He said to her, why? She said to him, every time I see you and you mention the name Fatima, I see you and I see there are tears that come down from your eyes. It shows that Amir al-Mu'mineen still had the affection for Fatima al-Zahra, salawatullah wa salamuhu alayha. That even after her death, he still had that affection for Fatima. He changed her name to Umm al-Baneen, the mother of the sons. And what sons did she bring him? Four sons. Abbas ibn Ali on the 26th year after Hijrah. 10 years later, Abdullah on the 36th year after Hijrah. 2 years after that, on the 38th year after Hijrah, she brought him Uthman ibn Ali. And 2 years after that, just before the martyrdom of Amir al-Mu'mineen, she brought him a son by the name of Ja'far. two questions arise. Amir al-Mu'mineen, did he call his son Abbas so that it's a characteristic that affects him, or is it a name with no meaning? He called him Abbas so that the word affects him. How? What does Abbas mean? Abbas means the person that frowns while on the battlefield, so that when he emerges on the battlefield, his presence is felt among the enemy, and they know he's come. He's not come for a joke. He's come for business. He's come to finish them off. أبا الفضل العباس ابن أمير المؤمنين. The second question that arises is, why did he name his son Uthman? Was it after Uthman ibn Affan? As in, Uthman was born on the 38th year of the Hijrah. Uthman ibn Affan died 2 years earlier. Did he name his son after Uthman ibn Affan or no? He didn't. He called him after Uthman bin Mad'un. Uthman bin Mad'un was who? He was one of the greatest companions of Amir al-Mu'mineen. He was the 14th convert into the religion of Islam. And he was known by Amir al-Mu'mineen to be a man of piety. A man that in the time of Jahiliyyah never touched alcohol. And hence what you find is that Amir al-Mu'mineen had a very, very close relationship with Abul Fadl al-Abbas that can be seen on many occasions. The first appearance for Abul Fadl al-Abbas was in the age of 11 in the Battle of Siffin. In the Battle of Siffin, one of the commanders of Muawiyah's army by the name of Ibn al-Shaza' came out. And he said, let Ali ibn Abi Talib come out and fight me one-on-one. Either I will kill him or one of my sons. He had 7 sons. Imagine, either this man's a crazy person or he's a very, very, very brave man. As in Ali's CV on the battlefield up until that day is quite good. You see, for example, in the Battle of Badr, 35 out of 70 by Ali's Dhulfiqar. Never mind the other battles. Amir al-Mu'mineen looked at Abul Fadl al-Abbas and said to him, come here next to me. He came next to him. He said to him, I want you to go out there. And I want you to wear a mask when you fight. And do not tell them who you are until I tell you. And whenever one of his sons comes out, I want you to attack him. The first came out, he finished him. The second came out, he finished him. The third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, and the seventh, Abbas finished them all. The father came out, said, Ali, I will finish you in the way you finished my sons. He finished him as well. Muawiyah's army were wondering, does Ali ibn Abi Talib finish people off in that way? They said, Ali, take off your mask. Remove your mask. At that moment, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Asadullah al-Ghalib, Ali ibn Abi Talib, came out from the back of the battlefield, riding his horse. He came out and he stood next to Abbas. Abbas was wearing the mask. They said, Abbas looked at him. He looked at his father. Shall I tell them who I am? He said to him, not yet. They asked again, take off your mask, tell us who you are. No response. On the third occasion, Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen looks at Abul Fadl al-Abbas and tells him, tell them who you are. He looks at them and he removes his mask slowly. And he tells them, Ana Qamar Bani Hashim Abul Fadl al-Abbas. I am the moon of Bani Hashim Abul Fadl al-Abbas. They said, there are already 2 moons in the army of Muhammad, Hassan and Hussein. He said, they are the sons of Muhammad and I am the son of Ali. And it is the role of the sons of Ali to protect the sons of Muhammad. And this proved and showed them that Abul Fadl al-Abbas was indeed a commanding warrior. And he was nothing, no one to be taken for a joke. And when you read the ziyarah of Abul Fadl al-Abbas, it's not only that he's a mujahid, of his qualities is not only that he's a mujahid. When you read his ziyarah, what does it say? Na'mal mujahid as-sabir. As-sabir, why? Because even before Karbala, Abul Fadl al-Abbas had to be patient. Where? When Imam al-Hasan, his older brother, was martyred, Abul Fadl al-Abbas had to be patient. Imam Hassan wanted to be buried where? He wanted to be buried next to his grandfather, Rasulullah. However, certain political figures, including Aisha and Marwan ibn al-Hakam, didn't allow this. They said, take his body out. As it was taken out, arrows enshrouded the body of Imam al-Hasan. Abul Fadl al-Abbas's patience had reached the limit. He looked at Aba Abdullah and he said to him, let me fight them. Let me at them. That's my big brother. Aba Abdullah told him, be patient. You will have your moment. He listened to Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. And that's why when Abul Fadl al-Abbas wanted to get married, he went to his mother, Ummul Baneen. Ummul Baneen said to him, no one can decide who you marry except Aba Abdullah al-Hussein. Look at the love, the devotion that she has for Aba Abdullah. Nobody can decide who you marry except Aba Abdullah. So he went up to Aba Abdullah. Aba Abdullah told him, marry Zakiyah, the daughter of Al-Fadl bin Ubaidullah bin Abbas. Two narrations. One mentions he had four sons, three present in Karbala. The other mentions two sons, Al-Fadl, hence Aba al-Fadl, and the second by the name of Ubaidullah. Who was Ubaidullah? The one who was in the hands of Umm al-Baneen when she heard about Karbala, and he fell. He was dropped onto the floor. And that's why when Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, was on his deathbed, he gave a wasiyya to all his children. Sayyida Zainab came, her wasiyya was to Imam al-Hasan. Imam Hussein came, his wasiyya was to Imam al-Hasan. Kulthum came, her wasiyya was to Imam al-Hasan. Al-Baneen then came and said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, my son Abbas, you've given a wasiyya to all of them, but my son, you haven't. He said to her, go and call Abbas. She went and called Abbas. Abbas came. He took Abul Fadl al-Abbas's hands and put them with his hands. And may Allah bless those hands. And he said to him, my wasiyya to you is with that stranger, Aba Abdullah. I want you to stand by him. And you see, when he went to collect that water, the lines of poetry he recites are unbelievable. It goes to show you a man that had devoted his whole life for Aba Abdullah. Ya nafsu min ba'd al-Husayn huni wa ba'dahu ma kunti an takuni. Hada al-Husayn warid al-manuni wa tashrabina barid al-ma'ini. Tallah ma hada fi'aludin. He goes, he picks up the water. As he picks it up, he wants to drink it. Imagine the thirst of Abul Fadl al-Abbas, days of thirst. He wants to drink it. Then he starts to speak with himself. He goes, oh self, after Hussein there is revival, but after this life there is humiliation if you're not on his way. This is Hussein drinking the syrup of death, while you drink the syrup of this cold water. He didn't accept it. This indicates a man that selflessly was giving everything away to the religion of Islam. And that's why no fitter words are more fitting than Aba Abdullah's words when Abul Fadl al-Abbas was gasping his last breaths. Al-an inkasara dhahri. Now my back is broken. That's why Imam Zain al-Abideen, salawatullah wa salamuhu alayhi, he says, Rahimallah Ammi al-Abbas. Laqad athara wafada wawasa akhahu binafsih. Fa'atahu Allah jinahain iwada yadayhi kama sana'a li Ja'far ibn Abi Talib. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآل بيته الطيبين.